How will Jupiter in Capricorn speak to you and your sign? Find out at NadiyaShah.com. Hello, fabulous Libra. Welcome to your horoscope for the month of December 2019, looking at life and love. I am your astrologer, Nadiya Shah. Thank you for being here. What an amazing month it is. We have an active and fabulous sky playing out for us right now. It is in the middle of the month, right around the 12th, that we will have this month's full moon. This full moon is taking place in fellow air sign Gemini, which is actually very encouraging because it means you'll be able to tap into this energy and use it to your advantage in some way. However, it is going to be, this full moon will be speaking in a connection of some tension with Neptune. Now, this full moon is happening in a part of the sky that has to do with understanding your place in the world. It's long distance travel, immigration, citizenship, higher learning, legal matters, political matters are covered here as well. So when we have Neptune speaking to a full moon like this, it can suggest a lack of clarity overall. Like, what's the next best step to take? What is a final answer? What isn't? All of this seems to be blurred at this time. It is not the time to seek legal advice. It's not the time as well, if you can help it, to submit important legal papers having to do with any matter of law, but also having to do with immigration or citizenship or higher education matters. If it is that you do need to submit documents like this, you try to do it as early in the month as possible or as late in the month as possible to get away from some of this full moon energy. Because it is ultimately this full moon energy that does suggest perhaps you end up missing some important parts of what it is that you need to submit. It's also possible at this time that what it is that you get in terms of whether it's acceptance, whether it is, you know, oh yes, we received it, and then it turns out that they didn't. Like, these are the types of scenarios that become possible here. And I would also add, you know, it is possible for us to get information and the people delivering it are sincerely believing that they're giving you the right information and it turns out not to be. That can happen. But this can also be a confusion because of people who might be misleading in some way. I'm so sorry to say that, but it does happen. And so it is going to be these matters that you have to pay attention to. If it is that you are traveling, okay, let's say you happen to be on the road and you're traveling and you're having a vacation somewhere in another country, this is where you're going to have to be especially vigilant. Just make sure you're, you know, doing the things that you do. If you are an experienced traveler, you know that there's certain things you need to do to make sure that you're okay, that you're getting the right information. Just do that, you know, like have a tour guide through your hotel and take the advice of the people at the hotel. You do things like that, you'll be just fine. Because it is going to be Mars speaking in harmony with Neptune under this same light. Now, all of this becomes that much more relevant if what is happening now is work-related in some way, like you're traveling for work or you're submitting legal documents because of something that's happening through work. That's where you want to be that much more careful to give this space, give it breathing space. And if you do, all will be well. But of course, the big news this month has to do with Jupiter. Right around the second of the month, Jupiter does change signs, bringing blessings to a brand new part of the sky for everybody. Now, I've spoken a lot about this already on my website with Jupiter specials on YouTube. Jupiter specials will be released in the first few days of the month, so be on the lookout for that video. But where it comes to this month, with Jupiter moving into the very foundation of your chart, the bottom of your sky, it is home that has the biggest blessings now, financial, emotional, and otherwise. It is as we get to the eclipse that takes place this month, right around Christmas Day, that you really start to see the blessings magnified. Now, the ancients believed that the sun meeting Jupiter in the sky, well, this was considered the luckiest day of the year. But what we are having now is a solar eclipse meeting Jupiter in the sky. And that just takes that luckiest day of the year energy and brings excitement and electricity to it. And so blessings could find you where you least expect it. And changes in circumstances come up in very surprising ways as well. You may not realize it as the month begins, but you may end up moving. And this could end up being a really great move for you. Buying, selling, new roommate, all of this coming together very quickly becomes possible for you. At the same time, it is members from your family of origin that can facilitate really surprising and big blessings for you at this time. The important thing is to stay open, right? With eclipses, you want to work with them by not working with them, by being receptive, by staying open, by going with the flow. It's when you bring a lot of intention to it that you start to narrow the pathways with which the universe can deliver its blessings. And the blessings are so big at this time that the best thing you could do is see where it is and how it is and through whom it is. Truly lovely blessings, delightful turns find you now. Where it comes to matters of love, it is going to be about 3 weeks into the month, right around the 20th, that Venus is going to move into fellow air sign Aquarius. Now, this is a part of the sky for you that has to do with flirtation and romance and what the heart truly desires. It has to do with getting your flirt on. Now, of course, with Venus being your ruling planet, this move is that much more important to you. On the one hand, outside of love, it is Venus moving in here for about a month. That is going to indicate a heightened creativity and a heightened feeling of you being a kid or enjoying the kids in your life. But where it comes to matters of love, this helps you to get your flirt on and to have fun all around. If you're open to meeting someone new, this really is one of the more fortunate energies that you're going to see to have a sense of being able to connect with new people. As long as you're doing something that you really love to do, that you are finding genuinely enjoyable for you to do, you allow love to find its way to you, and you find yourself just enjoying the flirt a little bit more, which in turn increases your options where it comes to matters of love. For those of you who are just getting to know someone, well, if you're just starting to date somebody, Venus moving into this part of the sky can be really a great placement for you. It is just such a fun energy, a light energy, and it'll allow you to continue to see if love can blossom here. And for those of you who are in an established bond, when Venus moves into this part of the sky, it tends to indicate romance. And there's a desire now to truly enjoy the company of your partner, to do something and more things that are romantic together. If you nurture that sense of a feeling, that sense of a flow, well, chances are it'll lead to a few memorable and sweet and loving moments. What I love about this month for you, well, there's so much here, but I love that solar eclipse. I know that eclipses can really go in all kinds of directions, but when you look at the fact that Jupiter is here and Jupiter is bringing blessings for a full 12 months, a little over 12 months into this part of the sky, well, it does tell me that what is changing now is good. Whether it is you seeing your past differently, whether it is that you feel free from your past, enough to be really excited about your future, or whether it is just good news all around where it comes to your family of origin, your parents in particular, what is happening now feels like an absolute blessing. Well, thank you so much for watching. You can get a video like this every week by logging on to NadiyaShah.com. Sign up to be one of my superstars. Superstars get expanded, exclusive videoscopes each and every week, unlimited access to special horoscopes and more. All of this in the superstar space. I look forward to meeting you there. It'll be a great month. Enjoy.